the previous experiment, we determined the natural period of our pendulum, and the value was 1.27 seconds. Now look at the formula. The natural period is independent of the suspended mass, which means that if we change the suspended object by another one having a different mass, the natural period must be or must remain the same. So we will follow the same procedure as in the previous experiment. We will shift the pendulum from its equilibrium position by a small angle, and then we will release it from rest. This is 10 degrees. We will measure the time for 10 complete oscillations and then divide by this time by, this time by 10. Eileen, are you ready?
Ready.
1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So what is delta T? 12.45 seconds. So T0 is equal to delta T over 10, which is equal to 12.45 over 10, and the answer is 1.245 seconds. As you see, the values are very close, so really T0 is independent of the suspended mass. Now, consider the formula. T0 is equal to 2 pi times the square root of L over the square root of G. 2 pi over the square root of G is constant, which means that T0 is directly proportional to the square root of L. Square what size? T0 squared is equal to 4 pi squared over G times L. Again, 4 pi squared over G is constant, so T0 squared is directly proportional to L. So we must verify this result experimentally. Now, the length of our cord is 40 centimeters, and with this length, we have this natural period. Now, I will replace the cord by another one having half the initial length. So the square of the new period must be half the square of the initial period. Lynn, give me the square of the initial period.
It's 1.61.
Okay, so it is 1.61 seconds squared. Now, the square of the new period must be half the initial value. So, divide the answer by 2, please.
It's 0.805.
Okay. So, we need to get this value experimentally. Now, this is our pendulum. Now, this new pendulum has a length of, as you see, it is 10 centimeters. Okay, now, again, it's 20 centimeters. Again, I will displace the pendulum by a small angle from its equilibrium position. We measure the time for 10 oscillations. So 10 degrees is like this. Are you ready, Lian?
Yes.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
It's 9.34.
So the new period is
9.24.
So it is 9.24. Sorry, this is the time for over 10. So this is 9.24 over 10 seconds, which is equal to 0.924 seconds. Now, please give me take the square of this value. So 3 0 prime squared
0.853.
Second square. Now, look at the calculated value and the experimental value. They are very close, and so this result is verified. The square of the natural period is proportional to L.